We must look at the scriptures in the light of Jesus. We must study the scriptures in the light of Jesus. 1 John chapter 5 verse 20. And we know, glory to God, and we know that the Son of God is come and hath given us an understanding that we may know him that is true, and we are in him that is true, even in his Son Jesus Christ. This is the true God and eternal life. Jesus came to give us an understanding about God. That is, our understanding is via Christ. We know God in Christ. Outside Christ, you cannot know God. John 17:3. And this is life eternal, that they might know thee, the only true God. The only true God. Kai rule of Bible interpretation. That is Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. If you miss Jesus, you miss God. Look at John 14 verse 1. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. So faith in Christ is faith in God. Faith in Christ is faith in God. You cannot believe God if you don't believe in Jesus, because Jesus is God revealed. John 14 verse 6. Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man approacheth God. The word cometh is to approach or to view God. No man cometh unto the Father. No man can view the Father but by me. Jesus unveils the Father to us. Jesus is the accurate exact. Jesus is the precise. Jesus is the total revelation of God. You cannot know God in Moses. You cannot know God in Elijah. You cannot know God in Jeremiah. You can only know God in Christ. Christ reveals God. Outside Christ, every impression of God will be erroneous. Only Christ is the precise. Jesus is the epignosis of God. Jesus is the epignosis of God. He's the accurate picture, the accurate revelation, the exact image of God. He is the image of the invisible God. We saw that. He is the image of the invisible God. Hebrews chapter 8, verse number 10. For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, saith the Lord. I will put my laws into their minds and write them in their hearts. And I will be to them a God, and they shall be to me a people. Pay attention now. Next verse. And they shall not teach every man his neighbor and every man his brother, saying, know the Lord. In the New Testament, all shall know me, from the least to the greatest. All shall know me, from the least to the greatest. Why? Next verse. For I will be merciful to their unrighteousness. That's God's true character. I will be merciful. When you know God in Christ, in Christ you will encounter the true character of God. And when you see the true character of God in Christ, you now know God. Then you can rely on God. Look at that verse 12. For I will be merciful to their unrighteousness, and their sins and their iniquities will I remember no more. So because of that character, the revelation of God's disposition towards man, he says, they will know me. They will know me. Today, we know God in Christ. Hallelujah. We know God in Christ. Christ is revealed to us, or Christ has revealed the Father to us. No man can know the Father but by Christ. So Jesus is the revelation of the Father. And that is why Jesus will take time to correct Moses, correct Elijah, correct John the Baptist. He corrected all of them. Why? They all testified of him. Jesus is not God's messenger. Jesus is the message. Glory to God. He's not God's messenger. Jesus is the message. Jesus is the logic. Jesus is God's thinking pattern. Jesus is God's thought. Jesus is the revelation of God's idea. Jesus is the reason behind creation. Jesus is the one for whom all things were made. So Jesus is the logic, the logos of God, the thinking pattern. To know God, you must know Christ, because Christ is God's mindset. Christ is God's mindset. You cannot know God outside Christ. So Christ reveals the Father to us. Christ reveals the Father to us. And today, we have seen God in Christ. We have seen God in Christ. Look at John chapter 14, verse 7. Glory to God. If you had known me, you should have known my Father also. And from henceforth, from henceforth, you know him and have seen him. From now, you know him and have seen him. Glory to God. From now, before now, no man has seen God. But from henceforth, which means from now, you know him and have seen him. It was a radical statement. So look at the way the disciples reacted. Next verse, verse 8. Philip said unto him, Lord, stop joking with us. Show us the Father. Show us the Father. And it sufficeth us. Look at the way Jesus answered Philip in verse 9. Oh, Gadaba. Jesus saith unto him, have I been so long time with you, and yet hast thou not known me, Philip? He that has seen me has seen the Father. And now sayest thou then, show us the Father. What Jesus is saying is, I am the Father manifest. I am the Father revealed. What Jesus is saying is, outside me there is no Father. I am the only Father that there is. Jesus is the Father revealed. And today, we have seen God in Christ. And I have news for you. We have not only seen him, he lives in us. Hallelujah. He lives in us. Look at Colossians 1:26. Even the mystery which had been hid from ages and from generations. It's been hid from the Old Testament people. But now, what Moses and Elijah could not see is made manifest to his saints. Next verse. To whom God will make known what is the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. Christ in you, the hope of glory. Hallelujah. So today, we have not only seen God in Christ, God lives in us. He lives in us in the person of Christ. Hallelujah. Christ in you, the hope of glory.